Hello again, fellow woodturners. I got a little different kind of video for you today. It's Christmas time around here, and I'm making some tops for my grandkids. And I bought this little top kit. It's just this little spinner deal, and you make a wood top that screws onto this M5 stud here, and then you wrap this string around this little stud, and then give it a pull, and off goes the top. The thing is, how am I going to mount the wood on the lathe? Well, you know, they make all these mandrels for, these projects. But I thought, well, I'll just make my own. And I thought, well, it might be kind of fun to show how that can be done on a wood lathe, because we're going to make it out of steel. So here I've got a piece of 3/8 or 5/8 cold rolled steel. And I wanted to show you this chuck in a little bit more detail. I've talked about it before, but these guys are so handy, and you know, this just threads onto your lathe. I have two of them, one for this lathe, and it's got 1 1/4/8 threads, and then I got one for mini lathe too that's got 1/8 threads on it. Now, I guess they call these a collet chuck, and you can buy them from, you know, Rockler or the various suppliers, wood turning supply, whatever. And they come in this, you get this pack here, this little kit. And it's got this one actually has a reducer in it, so you can screw it onto this one. Will fit one eighth spindle and 1 1/4, I think. So anyway, there's a reducing bushing in there, and then it comes with 5 collets. Now these collets, they're really ER32 collets. They're called in the machining world. And when you buy one of these from the wood turning suppliers, you get these 5 collets. You get a quarter, let's see, I think it starts at quarter, yeah. Quarter, 3/8, half, 5/8, and 3/4. And then I brought a couple of these collets just from our machine shop where we make all our tools and stuff, just to show you. These actually, you can buy these from machining suppliers like Enco, or you can find, actually the best place to buy these is online. You can get these collets in. I think the ER32 collet range is 1/8 to 3/4, and it's going to be in at least 16th, probably 32nd increments. I'm not sure, but you can look around on eBay. You can find just about any size you need. And the way this works is these just clip in here, snaps in there. And of course they're tapered, screwed on there, slip your part in there, and it's great for, you know, holding on to dowels and all that kind of stuff. Sometimes when I'm going to make a top, I'll just turn it down to 3/4 or something, and I can just hold it in this thing really good. And you know, they turn, so they're so concentric. They really, really work nice. So anyway, let's get busy here and make this. So we'll just tighten that in there with that guy, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap M8 threads in this. So we're going to use a I don't have the center drill that I need here. I'll have to run and get that. Be right back. All right, I'm back with the center drill that I need for this. This one is the number 3. And wood turners are probably not familiar with this stuff, but these are real common in a machine shop. And you can see there that it's got, we're gonna center drill, and then we're gonna also countersink, all in one operation. And the advantage with something like this is it's real short and it's real stiff. And we need all the advantage we can get when we're doing metal work on a wood lathe, because you know, they're not the most rigid thing in the world, at least when it comes to doing metal work. But we're going to try this here and see what we can do. Back this all the way up though first, get it as close as possible. Oop, it's coming out, to take all the slop out of it that I can. So we'll speed that up to 1,000 or so, a little better, and we'll just touch it. And in it goes. Working pretty nice. So, of course, this is a very basic metal lathe operation, done it a million times. I'm sure you guys that are machinists are gonna think it's kind of funny, but a lot of wood turners, I don't think they probably been exposed to this. So we got a spot drill and a little bit of a countersink there. So, and it should be pretty much right in the middle. That nice stiff center drill like that works out nice for that kind of thing. And of course, these, you know, you can get these anywhere too, eBay or Enco. Wholesale Tool is another source for these. They're handy little guys. So anyway, we're gonna tee up M5 threads. So we get a the right drill for that here. 4.2 millimeter is the size. Oop. So we'll put that in there and drill her out here. This is working super nice. No reason in the world why you can't do this with steel on a wood lathe. You just take it easy, keep things as close as you can. So that takes care of that part of it. You know, I've got the tap loaded in a little tap wrench already. And the trick, of course, is keeping this aligned. And one of the reasons you want to do this on a lathe is because you got the perfect alignment system here. And that would be this spring center here. What we'll do is put this guy in the chuck. And you see, before I put it in there, I should show you what it is. It's spring loaded. I believe these are just called a spring center. And they are made specifically to guide a tap. Make it nice and straight in a lathe or a drill press, mill, whatever you got. And the way this works, we'll just run this up here, and you can see that that compresses. So when you go to thread this in there, put a little tap magic on there. First, give it a little lube. Don't take much. Yeah, tap magic cutting fluid. So yeah, this is magic. Anyway, you go to run that in there, it keeps it nice and straight. And you can see that spring center is extending as we screw this in. And just wind it up again. Just a great way to run your tap in nice and straight. And of course, the same suppliers that I've been talking about on this video have these spring centers also. There, got to the bottom of the hole. I'll just back this out. Oh, whoops. And there we go. Then we'll just give it a little countersink with the hand drill here. You could put this in the tailstock too if you wanted to. There. Now, see how we did. Get my bolt here, M5 bolt. And a little wrench. And I'll screw that guy right in there. I think what I'll do, take this back out of here and clean it all up really good. Put a little drop of epoxy on it or thread locker or something. And that'll hold that in there real nice. Cut this off, whatever I need. And clean up the end and I'll have myself a nifty little M5 mandrel. And then you say, well, why don't you just buy one of those? Well, the thing is, I've already got these taps, and if I'm going to make a bunch of these tops, I got to have threads in my wood anyway. So I'll just tap that, and I'll tap my block of wood, run it in here, take it easy when I'm turning, and it should work out pretty good. And that way I can make this with my tap, so I don't need to buy it. And like I said, I'll be all set for tapping the wood blocks that I'm going to use for making tops. And the other thing is, you can buy a set of these taps and drills, and you get some 5/8 rod, you can make a whole slug of these things. So you can have all kinds of mandrels in different sizes. So there's a fun little project, a little bit different, turning or doing some metal work on a wood lathe. So anyway, hope you enjoyed it. Hope it's something that helps you out. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up on the YouTube channel and share it with your buddies if you would. Hey, thanks for watching.